Well, praise the Lord. We're here at the Miracle of Tony Davis. I mean to tell you, we just had a review of that movie and it was just simply magnificent. So what we're going to do now is do some interviews and let's see what the people have to say next. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with no other than Pastor Tony Davis. The Miracle of Tony Davis. Oh my God, that movie was just simply outstanding. I am just so blown away, thanking God. You know, I had an opportunity to live this with this man of God, you know. Talk.
You know, Pastor, I thank you. I remember when you came to the hospital, prayed over me, you and Betty Manns.
Yes, yes.
And, you know, this happened in 2003, but look what God has done.
Yes.
You know, the miracle. He healed me. I'm able to speak. I'm able to sing and dance on my leg.
Amen.
And I'm just thankful for what God has done. And look what God has done. A movie.
Beautiful.
We went through the book and the CDs, and now God has brought forth a movie.
Amen. You know, while I got you here, I'm believing that people can get healed, just like God healed you.
Yes.
Right now, let's just take a little time and just minister to the people just right now. Maybe it's forgiveness, maybe it's healing, whatever God is saying to you.
Speak it right now to your life in the mighty name of Jesus. Forgive. God told me to forgive. In order for me to receive healing, I had to forgive. So you must forgive. I know they did this and that to you, and some things we don't understand why, but God knows, and He's able to bring you out. And right now, I can see His hands coming inside that storm and pulling you out. So you got to stand still and know that God is able to heal you. He's going to heal your mind. I speak it right now. Heal your mind, your body, and your spirit. Stand still and watch the salvation of God. God is going to do a miracle with your name on it.
Yes.
Jesus' name.
Amen. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. Receive your miracle. Reach out and grab it in Jesus' name. We see many miracles. Your healing and forgive. Amen.
Okay.
Tony Davis, a loving husband, hard worker.
Look at that. Battery's right in there.
And man of God.
I said, God will find a way.
See, there you go with that God mess again, man. I can't even eat in peace in front of you.
Had his life changed in the blink of an eye.
I won't do this. You kill this man, it's on you.
Well, hello, ladies and gentlemen, and we're back, and I have with me
Victoria Wilson-Dara.
Oh, hi, Victoria. I'm Vicky. God bless you. That's a beautiful name. You know, tell me about the movie. What did you think about the movie? Do you have anything you want to tell the people out in the audience?
Okay. Well, you know, I'm kind of biased because this is one of my pastors in my team of Legionnaires.
Okay.
Yeah, so, but I love the movie. He's, you know, he's worked on it for so long, and we've been praying for it and supporting it for a long time. So to finally see it, it's just amazing. And the story is so real. I mean, it's a real true story. And the way that they alternate between heaven and earth, and that relationship with him and God is so vibrant and so beautiful. And
so what would you say to our audience out there? Why should they go see this movie?
This movie is going to inspire you. It's going to uplift you. It's going to strengthen your faith in God. And it's going to show you that God is still relevant in the world today,
amen,
and that He is still a God of healing and a God of forgiveness.
Amen, amen. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Go see the movie. Amen. Thank you so much.
Five shots, 10 holes, 5 enter points, 5 exit points. The guy nearly bled to death.
Okay, we're back here, ladies and gentlemen, and I have with me
Pastor Curtis Fields.
Okay, hi, Pastor. Oh, my God. Let's give the Lord a praise for Pastor. What do you have to say about the movie? What do you think about it? Any encouraging words why people should come see this movie?
The movie is a miracle of Tony Davis. Yes. It will revitalize you. Energy to know that God lives. This is a man who was shot 5 times, then made 5 extra holes, so he had 10 holes in his body. And God miraculously healed his body. The doctors, while he was unconscious, the doctors wanted to take off his leg. And his wife said, no, you can't do that. The very next day, The doctor said he was healed completely.
We won't give the whole story away. Tell me why should they go see the movie?
Because it would change your life.
Right. It's going to change your life, ladies and gentlemen. So go see the movie. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I have with me
Sonny Hughes.
Hi, Sonny Hughes. You didn't see the movie?
No, I did not. I missed
have you heard about the movie?
I've heard about the movie, and I'm amazed that a guy could live through that and that much and still be here and give as much as he has to the world and to other people.
Okay, well, they're going to have another showing, so you got to see the movie in about a few minutes. So, ladies and gentlemen, if you haven't seen the movie, you need to see the movie next.
Struggling to survive.
No, my husband is a man of God with a purpose on his life.
A test of faith.
I don't know why God allowed for it to happen, but God will have the glory.
Wow, did you see that movie?
I did.
What do you think of it?
I loved it because it reaches into the neighborhood. And I think it's a very timely message for young people who are beginning to think that violence is the answer.
All right. You know, when I hear you talking and talk about stop the violence, what would you have to say to people by seeing this movie? And how does it feel about violence? Just really quick and short.
Quick and short is a challenge because we're going through exactly what we're seeing the theme of today in the world. We see that young people are receiving the answer as lie down in the streets, shout, make noise, shoot each other, shoot at the police, and be shot of the police. And we heard it said in the Bible that if you take up the sword, you'll perish by the sword.
Amen, amen. So ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. We're getting these reviews. Your life will never be the same. See the movie. Get the movie. Let's do this. The Miracle of Tony Davis.
I don't know why God allowed for it to happen, but God will have the glory.
Ladies and gentlemen, we're getting some awesome reviews on this movie. Who do I have here?
My name is Ian Delgado. I mixed the sound and edited the film.
You did a good job on that movie. You know, just to wrap it up, what would you say to our audience just about the movie, to get see the movie or anything?
It's an inspirational message about God and just about life in general. It's about being at your lowest point and still coming and rising above it all.
Yes, and you did a very good job. I mean to tell you. Now, right here, I have another beautiful Jill. Who are you and what do you do? And talk to me.
My name is Joan Sturgis, and I'm the editor of Tony's book. And I just want to say, as the editor of his book, it was an awesome experience doing it because even though he had told me about the story, I had no idea until I actually had to sit down and edit it, just really how intense it was. And I just know that we have to do something as a nation about the crime that's going on in this country, and especially in terms of gang violence.
Amen, amen, yes. Amen. Amen. So, ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. You got to get the book and see the movie. Amen.
Of love.
Don't leave me. You promised God will see us through, and I believe you.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we just saw this awesome movie, and I have with me
Carlton Edwards, Pastor Carlton Edwards.
All right, and
Pastor Juanita Edwards.
All right. Now tell me, you know, tell our audience, what did you get out of the movie? What do you have to say to our audience? Why should they go see this movie?
Well, first of all, it's an awesome movie, and it shows the love of God and the miracle that when we truly love, trust, and believe and rely on God, what can happen? And the underlying story is a story about the young man that was sucked in by the gangs and how he got into a sinful activity and how God chose a man to show forgiveness and love, the love of God flowing through his heart. And it's a miracle. And I believe that everyone needs to see this movie, especially our young people. And we are really endeavoring to take this movie out to help us to stop the violence.
There you go, ladies and gentlemen. See the movie.
Obedience.
I want you to tell the world what you have seen. I want you to live a life demonstrating my power and forgiveness.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're not going to believe this. We have David B. in the house. This is one of DDT's. Yes, and you know that movie, it really blesses me to see the big screen and Tony Davis. What's in your heart? What's bubbling? What do you want to tell our audience?
Oh, man, I'm so excited. You know, the movie was so powerful.
Yes.
I mean, that it just bubbles awesome. My heart yes, because yes, we yes. have a lot of youth out yes. there and we got a lot of gang members mm-hmm. out there.
Yes.
This is just a tool
yes.
where God is able to work through the parameters
right.
of the movie just yes. to draw people
yes.
in.
Yes. Yes, yes.
And this movie is just so awesome.
Yes, it is.
And it just, it. I mean, I there is some words it's I just opposite. Can't and say.
I mean, we're going to wrap it up. You know what? Tony, we are proud of you.
Yes,
we thank God for you. And you know, everybody out there, see the movie, get the book. Your life will never be the same.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name, amen. Thank
amen.
You. Thank you.
Healing.
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Wow, we have a gentleman here. Can you tell me your name?
Zakele.
All right, Zakele. Yeah. All right, and you know, tell me what you thought about the movie.
I thought the movie was excellent. It's just a pity you couldn't have more of the people that it's speaking to. Okay. God is going to do something about it, but I wish that the young people will give them a chance.
Now, my question to you, would you go see the movie again?
Yeah.
All right, then. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. He will go see the movie again yeah. and again.
Yeah.
And take people.
And tell people, right, tell you know, about it.
Right.
We are living at a time when the yes. youth wants to be adult.
Yes, yes, yes,
know,
yes.
Going through right. the channels for them to nurture them,
right,
you know.
All right.
Growing.
Thank you. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Awesome reviews. Go see the movie, get the book. Yeah. Next.
And hope.
Men of God, I'm glad God brought you back from the dead.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with a legend. And your name is?
Dirk Davis.
All right, Dirk Davis. Some of you know him around the world. Amen. He's done all kinds of stuff from movie to recording and artists. And what do you have to say about the movie or anything you want to say to our audience?
Oh, it was fantastic.
Yes.
I really loved it. It really truly, you know, portrayed what actually took place at that time.
Right.
And the actors and I love Lou Gossett
yes,
Jr.
Yes,
it was just so wonderful. And, you know, God's going to have a great victory
yes,
with that.
Yes.
You know, and I just thank the Lord, the Almighty God,
yes.
who allowed this to happen. And I'm having such a wonderful time, and it's not over with yet. We're still not through.
Right now, it's not over with, and we're still not through. There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
The miracle of Tony Davis, a man of God who died for 30 minutes and lived to tell about it. This is his story.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I have another beautiful lady here. And your name is?
My name's Molly, and I work with the public health department.
Okay.
And I really think this movie should be shown in all the communities because violence is a public health issue.
Yes, it is.
And it really plays a big part, not just when the violence stops with the shooting, but it affects everyone who sees that, who witnessed to it. So this movie should be shown in all the communities and really get the support.
Yeah, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Show it everywhere. Oh my God, ladies and gentlemen, we're here. We just had the premieres, and I'm here with
DeFranz Forrest.
All right, and you saw him in the movie. Oh my God, what do you have to say about the movie? I know you know Tony personally. Just what's in your heart? What's bubbling inside?
I'm just very grateful that it finally came to fruition.
Yes.
We've been trying to put the movie out for a long time,
yes.
and God finally did it.
Amen.
And I'm very grateful.
Amen, amen. And I'm also here with
Mandel Frazier.
All right, Mandel Frazier, how you doing? Look over at that camera so they can see your face. Okay, okay. What did you think about the movie? What's going on inside of you?
I'm so proud of DeFranz.
Okay.
As a fellow actor, you know, it's always good to see and support your fellow thespians for
yes,
the most part.
Yes, yes.
So when I saw the trailer, I'm like,
yes.
you know what? I have to come to the screening just so I can support and, you know, hearing his story is amazing.
Yes.
Amen.
Thank you so much. God bless you.
God bless you too.
Yes. Amen. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. Well, ladies and gentlemen, we're here at the premiere of Tony Davis, The Miracle of Tony Davis, and I have with me
John Ray Walker.
All right. All right. What did you have to do with this movie? I know you had a lot to do with it. Maybe you can tell me what you had to do with it and any other words you want to say to the audience.
You know what? I was the writer and director of the film. In addition, I executive produced it along with Tony Davis and Bishop Beach. I did some stunts. I even played a misguided special needs.
I saw that.
Yeah, it took a lot of research for that.
That's awesome.
But had a lot of fun on the set.
Amen. And you did an outstanding job.
Well, can I tell you a secret about the film?
Please do.
Believe it or not, it took me about a week to write the script.
Okay.
And I never had watched Tony's TV specials or anything. It was just talking to him a couple times. And I think that's really what led the story, because after the story was done, we found out a lot of stuff that wasn't in Tony's book or hadn't been sent in interviews had actually been in the film. So there's some really interesting parallels about working on this film and energy and, you know, spirit and just being led by the spirit, I guess, on this. But it was awesome adventure. This was the first feature I did. It opened up different doors for me. I've had a chance to shoot for a lot of different networks, but this will always be one of my favorite projects.
You did an outstanding job. Ladies and gentlemen, see the movie, get the book. Thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with...
Kelsey Caesar.
Oh, my God, and this is the person that did all that shooting. Oh, my God, what do you have to say? I mean, the movie's on big screen, and you did an outstanding job. I just thank God for that. And what's words you want to maybe tell the audience, and what's going on inside of you right now?
I'm actually really excited. It took a while for it to release, but I'm so happy that it did, because it's not on my time or Tony's time.
Yes,
it's God's time. And so I'm really excited. I'm glad to see the message, and I got to really learn about Tony as well, because I never saw the project until today.
You didn't?
No.
Wow. Well, you did an outstanding job. And one thing I have to say, see the movie and get the book. Any closing remarks for the audience?
Forgiveness.
Forgive. That's the key. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with Dr. Nawani Alaus. Oh, my God. What did you think about that movie?
Oh, my goodness. It was awesome. Was awesome. Now, I know the testimony, mm-hmm. but when I saw the movie, it just, oh, wow.
Yes,
they did
an excellent job.
And I just wish everybody could see this movie.
Amen. So, ladies and gentlemen, see the movie, buy the book.
Starring Monte James as Tony, Shanae Humphrey as Chris, and Louis Gossett Jr. as the voice of God.
Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with...
Come in a little bit closer.
Greg Johnson.
Okay, Greg Johnson, God bless you. What did you think about that movie? What would you have to say to our audience about the movie? Would you...
I want everybody to see this movie, especially kids.
Okay.
And especially the police officer. Because they need to see it too, where they can get a better understanding.
Right.
And then they know how to dress somebody, you know.
Right.
So you cannot, kids got to quit following their peers.
Yes.
Because your peers will get you in trouble.
They will.
Because if you go to jail, they're not going to get you out.
That's it. So ladies and gentlemen, you got to stop the violence, see the movie, your life is changing. In Jesus' name, be blessed.
Amen.
Thank you. All right, God bless. Thank you. You look good, too.
I can't wear what you're wearing. But you
and
good.
I can't wear that either, but we make a good pair.
Yes.
All right.
We're
okay, ladies. Together. We're pairing. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with one of the actors in this awesome movie with The Miracle of Tony Davis, and you were the doctor.
I was Dr. Cutoff Leg.
All right, Dr. Cutoff Leg. And what is your name?
My name is Stephen Avakian, most of the time.
Most of the time, his name is that. You know, the movie, as I looked at it, was just simply magnificent. What's bubbling inside of you right now? Maybe you want to tell our audience why they should see the movie or why not to see it or whatever's in your heart.
Well, I think the beauty about the movie is not simply the acting or the story, but the living spirit in the movie. You know, there's episodes when we go to movies or see TV, there's episodes that we bring with us or take with us or own. But in this movie, it's not one episode. It's a living, breathing, life-giving event, one event after the other. And I think from a standpoint of appreciating and coming to a knowledge of it, and the more that I see the movie, the more knowledge that I have of how the Holy Spirit lives individually, even in the gang member.
Yes.
You know, the gang member didn't want to do it, and his grandmother...
Right.
Was saying, you got to watch who you're with.
Uh-huh.
So the lesson in that is, you got to watch who you're with.
Yes.
And if you better let them go, or they'll get you in a place where you can't be gotten.
Okay.
So I think the beauty of the movie has different characters and different parts.
Awesome.
And different things that will reach different ages of people. I would be for the older folks. I know that's hard to say. But the kids will reach the younger people. So everybody has a spirit in them.
Yes.
Everybody has a thought pattern that people can relate to, and I think that's what's very important about the movie.
Yes, Okay, you know what I got out of it? Prayer changes things.
Yes, I did too, Pastor. You know, and forgiveness.
And forgiveness.
Forgiveness really was a hold to my heart. It's forgiving in order to receive a healing from God. Yes. We have to let it go.
You got to let that thing go. Yes. Ladies and gentlemen, let that thing go. Amen. See the movie. I'm here with...
Nalea Hatchett.
All right. What did you think about that movie?
I thought it was really good, and I really learned something about it, and it was really good.
Okay. Would you suggest your friends to see the movie?
Yeah.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, there you have it. From young to old, see the movie. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, I'm here with Rosalind Davis. Oh, my God. What did you think about that movie?
I thought it was just awesome.
Yes.
I mean, it was such a blessing to see the power of God and forgiveness.
Yes.
And it just showed so many elements.
Amen.
You know, in the movie.
Amen. So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Forgive. That's what we're getting.
Forgive.
I'm Nuwani Alaus, and I'm so honored and privileged to be here with these two dynamic men of God who have, and we were here to preview the Tony Davis movie, and you, oh my God, you played him so well.
Thank you.
Tell me, what did you think about playing that part, and what your part in the film, and how did you come about being a part?
Excuse me, how did I come about the part? Well, I was actually, when Tony talked about this, I was actually the last one to actually audition for it. I was actually running late and didn't think I was going to make it. So that's how that came about. And with a blessing, he offered me the role, and a big transition for me at that time, because a lot of my work in the past had been comedy. And I was waiting to take on a challenge, something like this. And I'm just so blessed to have the opportunity.
Now, in the film, you seem so passionate. Like, I mean, you took on that role, and how did it feel to be in that position, to be living his testimony?
It felt good, because this is also one of the first initial times where I actually had to do some research. You know, I had watched the documentary about Tony. I read some of his book, you know, speaking to him. So I really had to kind of put my time in versus just reading a script and looking at some lines. You know, I had to internalize it. And with Don Ray Walker, you know, he's a great director, you know, especially the critical scene when Tony was shot. You know, that took a lot of prep, and Don Ray really helped me out with that. Yeah, that prep, you know.
Well, I tell you, I am just so excited. I'm here with this young man, and he's telling us about his part. And just the overall filming, the preview that we saw tonight, what do you think of that?
I loved it. I love that. And I was talking to Tony. It's amazing how you can have a serious drama but still find fun in it. It was great.
Okay, thank you so much for joining me here on this. Okay, God bless you.
Oh, my God, I'm here with Chris Davis. Oh, my God, wasn't that movie simply, what do you got to say? I mean, we did. Anyway, we worked so hard on all of this just to see it to come to pass. What do you have to say to the audience?
God be the glory.
Amen, amen. She's a woman of many words.
I hope everyone come to see the movie. I think souls would be saved in Jesus' name.
All right. That's why, keep on. You're going to be a preacher very soon in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Be blessed.
Whoa, it's going to be all right. Everything's going to be all right.
Yeah.
It's going to be all right. All right, all right, all right. Everything's gonna be all right. All right, all right, all right. Everything's gonna be all right. All right, all right, all right. Everything's gonna be all right. Jesus, where would I be? I'd be lost in the storm and could never come out. Oh, if it wasn't for Jesus, where would I be?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, I mean, the reviews are just coming. Oh, my God, they're awesome. And I thank God. I'm excited. I'm so proud of you.
Thank you
just for enduring. And I know people's lives are going to be changed. And right now I have Pastor Johnson, Henry Johnson.
Hello there. How you doing?
Hello. 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 You know, oh, my God. You go back a long ways, too, because I was looking in his file, and you're the one that wrote one of them letters for him when he was in school.
That's right. I sure did.
I sure did.
It's in the book.
That's
did you
right,
see it
that's
in the
right,
book?
That's
yeah.
Right. What do you think about this? I know you're so proud of Pastor Tony, and what's just going inside of you right now? Maybe look in the audience and that little red light. Talk to it.
I tell you, I am so blessed because this is a perfect historical place to see history being made. This is history. This is a capsule of Stop the Violence, a man who endured the violence, met with God. God gave him a second chance to go work for him if he would know how to forgive. And he did. And the movie depicted that in a fantastic way. Even as it portrayed it, everybody said, whoa. You have to see the movie to know what that whoa is all about.
All right. There you have it from Pastor Johnson. See the movie, and I encourage you to get the book. But you know what? I want to go a little further. There may be somebody on the other side of that camera, and they're holding unforgiveness. What would you have to say? Maybe one or two words, or just a little, what would you tell them?
Forgive, let go, and let God, and that way you will get your blessing. And you cannot get your blessing if you're holding on to a curse on someone else. Let go and let God, and he will deliver you.
Amen. Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Let go and let God. Wow, ladies and gentlemen. I mean, we're getting great reviews on this movie, The Miracle of Tony Davis, and I have with me
Pastor Troy Richard.
All right, Pastor Troy. What did you think about the movie? I mean, what's bubbling inside? Maybe you want to share with our audience?
You know, I'm excited about the fact, and one of the things that I was starting to share before I prayed was out of 2 Corinthians, I believe it's chapter 4, verse 1, where our God of mercy, when you receive mercy, like Tony's received mercy, you have a ministry.
Amen.
And then that word ministry, you know, in the Greek has to do with aid and has to do with relief. Yes. And what he's being used for right now is to bring relief to the masses.
Yes.
And what's wrong with those that are have a tendency towards violence? You know, one of the things that I saw is that oftentimes they're detached, and they disconnect from society, and then they become desensitized, and then dehumanized, and then you're likely to do anything. But what this is going to do is it's going to capture the attention of individuals that are going the wrong direction. And then they will find that they don't have to. There's a better way. And when they receive the mercy that God has for them, amen, they will go out and share and help someone else.
So you might be on the other side of that camera, and you know, you don't have to do what you're doing, and just receive the mercy, I hear, in Jesus' name, amen.